Advanced Spanish with Michel Thomas. Copyright 2006. In the content, Michel Thomas. In the recording, Hodder and Stoughton. Recording 1.
Buenos dias.
Buenos dias.
You all wanted me to come and continue the course which I gave you, and I decided to be here and to do it. And I'm very happy to give you a continuation, extension of the course. This extension will lead you into building up the entire structure of the language, which will be done again very easily. And again, I would like to recommend for you the same as before, to be relaxed, never to try to remember, because the responsibility for your remembering is in my teaching and not with you. Meaning, not to try, because trying is tension producing and will interfere with learning. What will be achieved now is building structure, all the tenses of the language. In other words, I like to avoid using the word grammar. This is what you're going to get, but easily and quickly. Vamos a comenzar. Vamos a empezar. We're going to start.
Okay.
And we're going to start with a review first of the present tense. The key to the whole present tense is to stress always the syllable before last of any verb. Therefore, if you want to say to buy, would be comprar.
Comprar.
And I am buying it would be
compro.
It. I'm buying it.
Lo compro.
Right. Lo compro. I'm buying it. I do not buy it. I don't buy it because it's very expensive.
No lo compro porque es muy caro.
Right. No lo compro porque es muy caro. Why don't you buy it, señor?
¿Por qué?
¿Por qué?
¿Por qué no lo compra, señor?
Yes, say it again.
¿Por qué no lo compra, señor?
Right. ¿Por qué no lo compra? Why don't you buy it? Why aren't you buying it?
¿Por qué no lo compra, señor?
So, why don't you buy it or why aren't you buying it? It's the same, ¿por qué no lo compra? We have three types of verbs in Spanish. I divide them up into two categories, and I will say either the verb ends in R, meaning AR. I call them the R verbs. The AR is R. That's one category. Or they don't end in AR and R, like air or ear, the other category. And in the present tense, with all verbs, you stress, you push down on the syllable before last. For I, after you push down, you will surface on O. The O is pronounced O like in obey. So, comprender, to understand, I understand would be
comprendo.
Comprendo. Push down, comprendo, and you surface on O. Comprendo. For to understand, you can also say entender. So I understand it would be
lo entendo.
Usually, if you push down on an E,
oh, yes.
In pushing down, the E will cave in and split into IE.
Lo entiendo.
Right. Lo entiendo. Yes. In comprender, you have the E between PR and ND. It holds up, so it will not split into comprendo, but comprendo, and comprende. For you understand comprende, or of entender, you understand?
Entiende.
Entiende. So if you want to say, why don't you understand me?
Porque no me entiende.
Right. Porque no me entiende. You're talking to señor, señora, señorita. But if you're talking to your friend Roberto, Roberta, why don't you understand me?
Porque no me entiendes.
Right. Porque no me entiendes. And if you're talking to several people, why don't you all understand me? Could be a couple or many people.
¿Por qué no me entienden?
Right. ¿Por qué no me entienden? And they don't understand me.
No me entienden.
Right. No me entienden. He's preparing it for me.
Prepara me.
Say it again. He's preparing it.
Lo prepara.
Right.
For para me.
Right. Lo prepara para mí. You can also say in Spanish, he's right now preparing it for me. Right now, he's meaning in the process of preparing it for me. You can say, lo prepara para mí. Or, he's in the process of preparing it for me would be?
Esta.
Not, esta means this. Esta noche, this night.
Está.
Right.
Preparando. No.
Right. What's wrong?
Está preparando. Dolo.
Yes, say it again once more. Está
preparándolo.
Right. Está preparándolo. Ando is the ing on the R track, and yendo the ing on the other track. Está preparándolo. But you also can put the lo way up front and say
lo está preparando.
Right. Lo está preparando ahora. He's preparing it right now. Why don't you do it with me?
¿Por qué no lo hace?
Right. ¿Por qué no lo hace? Why aren't you doing it, Roberto?
¿Por qué no lo haces?
Right. ¿Por qué no lo haces? Why don't you do it, all of you?
¿Por qué no lo hacen?
Right, ¿por qué no lo hacen? But he's doing it right now. He's right now in the process of doing it, would be?
Está haciéndolo
right.
Ahora.
Está haciéndolo ahora. O lo está haciendo. Ando, yendo for ing, with estar, is used only when one is in the process of doing now. If you want to say, he's leaving right now, está saliendo, he's right now on his way. But you cannot say, está saliendo mañana, as you do in English, he's leaving tomorrow. So what one is right now in the process of doing. I don't understand what you're saying would be. I don't understand.
No comprendo.
Uh-huh. What? In the middle is...
Lo que.
Once more.
No comprendo lo que...
You're saying?
Dice.
Yes, say it again.
Dice.
Right. So say it again. No comprendo lo que... Once more.
No comprendo.
A little more.
No comprendo.
Right.
Lo que dice.
Right. No comprendo lo que dice. Because to say, to tell is? Decir is the pushing down on the E. Usually it splits into IE, so originally it was dies, it became dice. Easier to pronounce than dies. So look at dice. They're telling me would be
me desen, des.
What is you're telling me?
Dice.
Right. For they, you always hook on the end to whatever you have for you, singular, or he, she, it.
Dicen.
Right. So dicen would be they are telling. Why don't you tell me if you're talking to several people?
¿Por qué no me dicen?
Right. ¿Por qué no me dicen? You're talking to your friend Roberta or Roberto. Why don't you tell me?
¿Por qué no me dices?
Right. Good. ¿Por qué no me dices? But for we, you always go back to the infinitive, always go back to the full verb. If you want to say, we are telling you.
Decíamos.
Without the R. You always drop the R.
Decimos.
Decimos. So, le decimos. To understand is.
Entender.
Entender. Or.
Comprender.
Comprender. So, if you want to say, why don't you understand me? With comprender would be. You're talking to señor, señora, señorita. Why don't you understand me?
¿Por qué no me comprende?
Right. ¿Por qué no me comprende? Or with entender.
¿Por qué no me entiende?
¿Por qué no me entiende? In comprender, if you push down on the E goes up between the PR and then the comprendo, comprende. Whereas entender, it splits into IE. Entiendo, entiende, and so on. To start, to commence is
commence. Empezar.
Empezar or comenzar. Comenzar or empezar. Why don't you start, señor? Why don't you start?
¿Por qué no empiezo?
Well, you push down on the E.
Empieza.
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 Right. ¿Por qué no empieza? Why don't you start? You're talking to several people. Why don't you start?
¿Por qué no empieza?
Right. ¿Por qué no empiezan? Empiezan.
Empiezan.
Empiezan. It splits the E, caves in, and splits into IE. ¿Por qué no empiezan? I'm starting now would be.
Empiezo.
Right.
Ahora.
Empiezo. Ahora. Why don't you start, Roberto?
¿Por qué no comienzas? ¿Por qué
right.
no comienzas?
¿Por qué no comienzas? Or, with empezar, why don't
¿Por
you
qué
start? ¿Por
no
qué? Yes.
Empiezas.
Más o menos.
¿Por qué no empiezas?
Right. ¿Por qué no empiezas? What is to buy?
Comprar.
Comprar. I'm not buying it.
No lo compro.
No lo compro. Why don't you buy it, Roberto?
¿Por qué no lo compras?
Right.
Compras.
Right. ¿Por qué no lo compras? Why don't you all buy it?
qué no lo compran?
Right. ¿Por qué no lo compran? We are buying it.
Lo compramos.
Lo compramos. If you want to say buy, buy the house. Buy, the command, the imperative. Whenever you use the imperative, you switch tracks. In the present tense, we have two key sounds. We have two key sounds, either if it is an R verb, after you push down, put the stress on the syllable before last, then you will surface on A. If it is on the R threat, ta or an or as, or if it is not on the R threat, ear or ear, after you push down, you surface on E. So A and E are the two key sounds for the present tense. You push down on the syllable before the last, on the penultimate syllable. For I, for the first person, you surface on O on both tracks, on both categories of R or not R verbs. If you switch those tracks from A to E and E to A, you are in the imperative. That's a command. You are not buying the house, or he is not buying the house, would be?
No compra la casa.
La casa, right. No compra la casa. But if you want to say buy the house.
Compre la
casa. Compre la casa. Compre. In switching tracks, you are now in the imperative, the command, compre. Don't buy it, would be?
No lo compre.
No lo compre. You're talking to Roberto, don't buy it.
No lo compres.
No lo compres. You're talking to a couple, don't buy it. To several people.
No lo compren.
Right. No lo compren. But if you use the positive command, then the pronoun, él, to me, or you, and them, whatever, is hooked on. Like, if you want to say, buy it, then you do what you do in English, buy it, not it, buy, but buy it, which would be, cómprelo, cómprelo, buy it. That only goes for the positive command, positive imperative, not the negative. If you want to say, don't buy it, no lo compre, no lo compre. You're talking to several people, buy it. Comprenlo, comprenlo. Don't buy them would be, you're talking to several people.
No los compren.
Yes, say it again.
No los compren.
Right. No los compren. Mm-hmm. And you're talking to Roberto. Don't buy them.
No los compres. I pushed too much on the second.
Yes, once more.
No los compres.
Right. No los compres. It's curious that in the positive command to Roberto, you do not switch tracks. You don't switch tracks, but you drop the S. So if you want to say, buy it, Roberto, would be cómpralo, cómpralo. To call is llamar, llamar, llamar. I am calling you would be, I'm calling you.
Le Llamo.
Right. Le llamo. I'm calling you, Roberto.
Te llamo.
Right. Te llamo. He's calling me.
Mi llama.
Right. Mi llama. Why don't you call me Roberto?
Por qué no me llamas?
Right. Por qué no me llamas? Why don't you all call me?
Por qué no me llaman?
Por qué no me llaman? We are calling you.
Le llamamos.
Right. So llamar. So llamamos. Le llamamos. We are calling you, Roberto.
Te.
Te.
Te. Llamamos.
Te llamamos. If you want to say, call me. Call me tomorrow. Call me would be.
Llámeme.
Right.
Mañana.
Llámeme mañana. Don't call me today.
No me llame.
Right.
Hoy.
No me llame hoy. Yes. So, again, in the positive command, the pronoun or pronouns will be hooked on, but only in the positive command. So, no me llame hoy. Now, you're talking to Roberto. Don't call me today.
No me llames, Ano.
Yes.
Oh, it's only in the positive.
It's negative.
Yeah.
Don't call me.
Gotcha.
Yes. Okay.
Yes. No me llames.
No me llames. Right. No me llames. Switch tracks. Yes. But. Now comes the but. In the positive command to Roberto, you don't switch tracks and don't use yes. So if you want to say in the positive command, call me.
Llámame.
Right. Llámame. Llámame. Call me. Roberto, Roberto, llámame. If you talking to señor, señora, señorita, if you want to say, call me, would be
llámeme,
llámeme, right? There's a difference between llámeme or llámeme. Yes. So you see the importance, the vowel, all the vowel sounds, even unstressed, have to be very clear. It's a very important difference between llámame or llámeme, depending on who you're talking to. We have verbs with for the first person for I in the present tense. You have the G-O. I call them the go-go verbs. For instance, to have is
tener.
Tener. Tener is to have, yes. You have would be
tiene.
Tiene. Why? Because you push down on the E and it splits into IE. Tiene. So why don't you have it for me?
Porque no lo tiene para mí.
Right? We don't have it.
No lo tenemos.
No lo tenemos. Right. But for I have, instead of saying tieno, and sticking in the G, tengo, then it holds up the E, and it doesn't split. So tengo is I have. I have it would be?
Lo tengo.
Lo tengo, I don't have it.
No lo tengo.
No lo tengo. But I have to see it. I have to, I must, is tengo.
Tengo que.
Tengo que. Tengo que is I have to, I must. So I have to see it would be?
Tengo que verlo.
Right. Tengo que verlo. So we have a few verbs. We, for I, in the present tense, you have a go, geo, like tango is one. To say or to tell is
decir.
Decir. And you say or you tell is
dice.
Dice. And I tell used to be dico.
Digo.
It became digo. Digo. So it's another go-go. So I'm telling you, señor, would be
le digo.
Le digo. I'm telling you, Roberto.
Te digo.
Te digo, yes. Why don't you tell me, Roberto?
Por qué no me dices?
Right. Por qué no me dices? Why don't you tell me you're talking to a couple?
Por qué no me dicen?
Por qué no me dicen? So far we have I have, which is
tengo.
Tengo. I'm telling or saying
digo.
Digo. We have another situation like to have, which is tener. We have to come, which is
venir.
Venir. Venir. V-E-N-I-R. Venir. Again, the V and B have the same sound. Pronounce with your lips, venir. So he's coming with us would be
viene.
Viene.
Con usted.
Con nosotros.
Con nosotros.
Con nosotros. Viene. He's coming. Again, push down on the E. It splits into IE. Viene. We're coming would be
venimos.
Right. Venir, venimos. But I'm coming, I come, is instead of vieno, vengo. Here another go-go. So it's like tener, that becomes tengo, venir becomes vengo. Vengo. V-E-N-G-O, vengo. So we have tengo, we have digo, we have vengo, and to do or to make is
hacer.
Hacer. So what are you doing would be
que hace.
Que hace. Yes. What is to know?
Saber.
Saber. Do you know it?
Lo sabe.
Right. Lo sabe. You're talking to Roberto. Do you know it?
Lo sabes.
Right. Lo sabes. Why don't you know it? You're talking to several people.
¿Por qué no lo saben?
Right. ¿Por qué no lo saben? We know it.
Lo sabemos.
Lo sabemos, yes. But I know is an exception. Instead of sabo, you just say, se. Lo sé, I know it. And se is spelled S-E with an accent over the E. Se. So I don't know it would be?
No lo sé.
No lo sé. We have to make a distinction in Spanish with to know. There are two verbs for to know in Spanish. In English, to know expresses two different meanings. One is for general knowledge, which is saber. The other one is to know somebody, to be acquainted with somebody, or to know a city, to be acquainted with it, would not be saber, but conocer. C-O-N-O-C-E-R, conocer, with ser and seer verbs. We have a little problem for I, because if you want to say I know, it's actually conocer, conozco. But for the rest it's normal, conoce, conocer, conoce. So if you want to say I don't know him, would be
no, no, conosco.
No lo conosco.
I don't know her would be.
No la conosco.
Right. Non la conosco. Do you know Pedro?
Conosce Pedro.
The A is used with, it's a very personal A in Spanish. If one sees a person, so it's with a direct object, not to a person. So the A does not mean here to, but to like a person, to see a person, with a personal one throws empty R. If you want to say, do you know my friend, would be, conosce a mi amigo. Not just conosce mi amigo, my friend, mi amigo, but only goes for persons, for people. Do you know Madrid, would be, conosce Madrid. I don't know him, would be,
No lo conosco.
I don't know it. That is a different knowledge.
No lo sé.
Right. But let's go back to the Google verbs. So we have, so far we have, I have.
Tengo.
Tengo. Yes, and I'm saying or telling.
Digo.
I'm doing or making is.
Hago.
Yes, H-A-G-O. I'm doing it.
Lo hago.
Yes, I have it.
Lo tengo.
Yes. I'm telling you, Roberto.
Te digo,
yes. I'm coming.
Vengo.
Mm-hmm. And to leave, salir, is salgo, for I'm leaving. I'm leaving tomorrow would be?
Salgo mañana.
Right. At what time are you leaving?
A qué hora sale?
Right. A qué hora sale? So again, I have?
Tengo.
I come?
Vengo.
I'm doing?
Hago.
I'm telling,
digo,
and I'm leaving,
salgo.
Then we have to put is poner, P-O-N-E-R, and I'm putting is pongo. So I'm putting it here.
Lo pongo aquí.
Where are you putting it?
Donde lo pone.
So why don't you put it here, Roberto?
Por qué?
Mm-hmm.
No lo pones aquí.
Right. Por qué no lo pones aquí? You can have composite verbs of poner. And it will correspond to the English pose. For instance, componer would be to compose. Oponer, to oppose. Suponer, to suppose. So I suppose would be?
Supongo,
right. Then we have to bring, which is traer. To attract, to pull in, to bring, traer, T-R-A-E-R, traer, which is also a Google verb, traigo, T-R-A-I-G-O, traigo. I'm bringing it would be?
Lo traigo.
Lo traigo. Okay, I'll throw in another one. Yes. To hear is oír, oír with ears, yes. To hear, oír, O-I-R, yes. And I'm hearing is oigo, oigo. With all the go-go verbs, if whenever you want to use the imperative, the command, all the go-gos turn into gagas. They all become gagas. For instance, if you want to say, come with me, would be venga, venga conmigo, venga, venga. If you want to say, don't leave, no,
no salga,
no salga, yes. You're talking to Roberto, don't leave.
No salgas.
Right, once more.
No, no salgas.
No salgas. You're talking to several people, don't leave.
No salgan.
No salgan. Yes, once more.
No salgan.
No salgan. Mm-hmm. How would you say, tell me. Dígame. 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 Uh-huh. Don't tell me.
No me diga.
No me diga. Who would you say, tell it to me? Whenever you have two pronouns, the personal always comes before the other. Uh-huh. So tell it to me.
Dígamelo.
Tell is again.
Diga.
Uh-huh. Diga is tell. So don't change diga to diga or whatever.
Dígamelo.
No, you still changed it.
Dígamelo.
Right. Say it again.
Dígamelo.
It doesn't hurt to push it down a little deeper, which would be dígamelo. Dígamelo. Tell it to me. But don't tell it to me would be
no me lo diga.
Right, no me lo diga. How would you say, tell it to him?
Dígaselo.
Thank you. Right, dígaselo. So dígaselo could also be tell it to her, yes. It could also mean tell it to them.
Right, all three.
So if you want to clarify it, you will say dígaselo. A él, dígaselo a ella, dígaselo a ellos, dígaselo a ellas, if them are all females. So, don't tell it to him, tell it to me, would be.
No se lo diga.
Right, no se lo diga, don't tell it to him. Or no se lo diga, diga a él, if you want to. If it needs clarification, tell it to me.
Dígamelo.
Right. No se lo diga, dígamelo. Don't do it.
No. No haga.
Right. All the gogos become gagas in the imperative and the command. So again, don't do it.
No lo haga.
Right. No lo haga. Yes. Don't you do it, Roberto. Don't do it.
No lo hagas.
No lo hagas. And don't do it, all of you.
No lo hagan.
No lo hagan. Yes. And do it, all of you, do it.
Háganlo.
Right, háganlo. Yes, háganlo. Mm-hmm. Now, what is to put?
Poner.
Poner. I'm putting it here.
Póngolo aquí.
No, the pronoun comes after the verb only in three instances. For instance, after if you have the full verb, the infinitive, I want to do it. Quiero hacerlo. I can do it. Puedo hacerlo. But there is an option. De hacerlo. You can also say, I cannot do it. No lo puedo hacer. You can put the law way up front. The same if you want to say, I'm right now in the process of doing it. Estoy haciéndolo. Or lo estoy haciendo. So here we have two instances in infinitive or ando yendo, where you either hook it on after or put the it, me, any pronoun before. The third instance is the positive imperative, the positive command, where you don't have an option. You have to hook it on. So therefore, all the go-go's become gagas. If you want to say, do it, would be
hágalo. Hágalo.
Say it again.
Hágalo.
Hágalo. Yes, hágalo. But don't do it.
No lo haga.
No lo haga. Only the positive command, hágalo. So I'm doing it would be
lo hago.
Lo hago.
Yes. Hago.
Yes. I'm not doing it.
No lo hago.
No lo hago. Yes. Why don't you do it?
¿Por qué no lo hago?
Why don't you do it, señor?
Listen slow. ¿Por qué no lo hace?
Right. ¿Por qué no lo hace? Why don't you do it, Roberto?
¿Por qué no lo haces?
Right. ¿Por qué no lo haces? Why don't you all do it?
¿Por qué no lo hacen?
Right. ¿Por qué no lo hacen? Yes. Yes. You're doing good push. Yes. ¿Por qué no lo hacen? Yes. Do it. All of you.
Háganlo.
Very good. Háganlo. Háganlo. But don't do it now.
No lo hagan.
Right.
Ahora.
No lo hagan ahora. So put it here would be señor.
Póngalo aquí, right. Señor.
Yes. Don't put it there. There is allí. Yes.
No lo ponga allí.
Right. No lo ponga allí. Bring it would be.
Tráigalo.
Very good. Tráigalo. So bring it. Think of trying. Yes. Tráigalo. Bring it. Bring me something.
Tráigame algo.
Right. Tráigame algo. Bring it to me.
Tráigamelo. Tráigamelo.
Right. Tráigamelo. Bring it to me. Don't bring it to me today. I don't need it today.
No lo.
Don't bring it to me.
No lo. No me lo traigo. Traiga.
Right. Say it again.
No me lo traiga.
Today.
Hoy.
Because I don't need it today.
¿Por qué no necesito?
Once more, I don't need it.
¿Por qué no lo necesito?
Right. ¿Por qué no lo necesito hoy? I don't need it today. So, no me lo traiga. Don't bring it to me. I hear it would be lo, with my ears, lo hoy.
Oigo.
Right. Oigo. Lo oigo. Yes. Hear it. Hear would be
oigalo.
Oigalo.
dice? Me dice?
Me dices, you're saying, you're telling me.
Me lo dice.
Me lo dices, you're telling it to me.
No se lo dice.
Pues por.
Me lo dice.
Me lo dice.
No.
Me lo dice is you are telling it to me, or he is telling it to me, or she is telling it to me. No me lo dice would be you are not telling it to me, he is not telling it to me, or she is not telling it to me. But I want you to say, tell it to me. Not you're telling it to me. Tell it to me.
Dígamelo.
Yes, once more.
Dígamelo.
Dígamelo, right. Dígamelo, yes. Now, don't tell it to him.
No digaselo. No se lo diga.
Right. Once more. Say it again. No.
No se lo diga.
Right. No se lo diga. Only in the positive imperative and the positive command that you hook it on diga. Yes. So tell it to him would be
Dígaselo.
Dígaselo spelt in one word. All the three words, dígaselo, but spelt in one word, dígaselo. So dígaselo, tell it to him, but don't tell it to him today.
Pero no se lo diga hoy.
Right. Pero no se lo diga hoy. So we still have a little problem with the positive command to Roberto. Now what do we do with the go-go verbs?
Yes.
The answer is very simple. Just to drop the go altogether in the imperative, in the command. Tell me. Roberto would be
Disa.
Tell me.
Me disa. Oh, it's a command. Disa me.
What is this? What's the sound?
When I went from dice,
huh?
I changed from dice, I changed.
No, you drop it all together. Good syllable. From Digo, you'd have to go and you get...
Oh, I see. Tell it to me. Dime.
Right. Just D-I. D.
Dime.
So, if you want to say, tell it to me.
Dimelo.
Dimelo. Yes, dimelo. Yes. But don't tell it to me, Roberto, would be...
No me lo digas.
Right. No me lo digas. Well, you're talking to several people. Don't tell it to me.
No me lo digan.
Right. Yes. No me lo digan. But not to Roberto, with all the go-go's, you just drop the go altogether. So again, if you want to say, tell it to me, Roberto.
Dímelo.
Dímelo. Yes, dímelo. If you want to say, come with me, Roberto.
Ben?
Right. Right. Ben. Ben.
Okay.
Ben conmigo. Yes.
Ben conmigo.
Ben conmigo. If you want to say, have it. You won't really use it, but still.
Tenlo.
Right, tenlo, yes. Mm-hmm. But you will often, we often use, put it here, would be Roberto. Ponlo. Ponlo aquí.
Aquí.
Yes. Don't put it there, put it here, Roberto.
No lo pongas.
Yes.
No lo pongas.
Right. No lo pongas. No lo pongas.
No lo pongas. Aquí.
Yes. Because Roberto wants to hear, yes.
Yes. Yes.
No lo pongas. Pongas. How would you say it again? No lo.
No lo pongas.
No lo pongas aquí. Put it here, Roberto.
Ponlo aquí.
Right. Mm-hmm. If you want to say to Roberto, leave.
Sal.
Right. Don't leave, Roberto. Don't leave.
No salga. No salga.
Yes. No salga. Don't leave, all of you.
No salgan.
What's more?
No salgan.
Yes.
Too many pushes.
Yes.
No salgan.
That was good. Because you're doing so well now with the imperative for the command tense, I'm tempted to do something else. To do something else with the imperatives with the command. Because I'm going to turn what you just have been doing with the imperative of the command, I will turn it into a command tense. Just what we have been doing, but as a whole tense. I will explain to you now when to use that tense. Well, let's put a name on the tense I'm going to give you now. Usually, I don't like to use grammatical terms, but I'll just drop it and then we can forget it. What I'm going to explain to you is how to use the subjunctive very easily, because I call the subjunctive the command tense. Let's look at it as a command tense, because you will use everything what you have been doing now as a tense. The question is when to use it. I want to do it now because actually it's also part of the present tense. In the present tense, you have the imperative, the command, it's the same push which you use for the present tense, you also use for the imperative, for the command. And now we will add to it, with the same push, also the command tense. Now, but first, before going into it, I want to explain to you when to use it and why.
Yeah.
Because in English, we hardly use it, or rarely, but one may, or one can, or one does sometimes use it. I'll give you an example. If you want to say, I want you to be here, instead of I want you to be here, you can also say, I want very much that you, I want very much that you
be here.
First of all,
I want very much that you be here.
That you be here. You be and not you are, because it's very important for you to be here. Instead of, it is very important for you to be, you want to be more emphatic, and you won't say in English, because it's very important that you
be here.
That you be here, and not that you are here. You see the difference between you are and you be. At what time do you want me to be there? At what time do you want that I
should be here.
That I
be here.
That I be there. Yes.
not that I am there, that I be. We have that I be, that you be, that he be, that everybody be, that nobody is, and we have be. In a way, I could also say it as a command tense, meaning be here. Be is an imperative here in English, yes. Be here at 7 o'clock. Be here. We have to understand that first in English so that we know what we're doing. Let's say he must go there today because it's very important that he must go, but because it's very important that he
go there. That he
right.
be there. That he,
no, that he
go there.
That he go there is right.
Yeah.
Yes. Not that he goes. People in the UK or in the United States will say that he goes, yes, which is incorrect English, that he go, or because he must do it, because it's very important, it is necessary that he
do it,
that he do it, not that he does it,
yes,
that he does it would be incorrect English. Again, we have it command tense. Do it. Go there. It is very important, it's necessary that he do it. Because I want that he do it. I want that he do it. What you want me to do, what you want that I or that he do. So in some cases, you recognize the command tense, the subjunctive in English. In English, mostly you will avoid it except for emphasis, whereas in Spanish you use it quite a bit, quite a lot. And if you're using what we just have been doing with the command and we turn it into command tense, you have the whole thing. Well, we have been playing around with the go-go's, for instance. From all other verbs, you just switch tracks from A to A and A to A, and you're in it. The reason why it is used a lot is because it expresses an element of doubt, of uncertainty. If you say that it is necessary that you be here, well, I don't know if you're going to be here. Yes, it is necessary. It is important that you be here.
But you might not be here.
Right.
Yeah.
And that element of doubt, of uncertainty, is useful, not just with to be, as here in English, or with he, that he go, or that he do it. But in Spanish, you can use it with all verbs, which means all you do is switch track from A to A or A to A, and the go-go's become gagas. The other thing is that with the subjunctive, you don't have to bother and think, Roberto, Roberta, I don't switch tracks, or I don't use the gold. In the subjunctive, you don't have to worry about it, because with everybody, the go-go's become gagas, and you switch tracks from A to A and A to A. Now let's try it. It is important that you be here. Would be
es importante.
Give me more.
Es importante.
No, you gave me two pushes.
Es importante.
Es importante.
Es importante.
That you be.
Okay.
Es, from estar to
que este.
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 Right. Es importante que esté aquí. But the other beautiful thing is that for the subjunctive, you don't have an O for I. So este would be that I be, you be, he be, she be, it be, or they estén. Or for you, Roberto, estés, and you have the whole thing. No, if you want to say, it is important that you call on me.
Es importante que me llame.
Right. Que me llame. It's an R verb. You switch to A. Que me llame. It's muy importante que me llame. That you call me. Or that you all call me. Es importante que...
Que me... llamen.
What's more?
Llamen.
Right. It's importante que me llamen. Yes. It's very important for you, Roberta, to call me later.
Es importante que me llames.
Right.
Muy tarde. Yes.
Más tarde.
Más tarde.
Yes. That was very clear, no? I heard yes. Es importante que me llames. It is not necessary for you to wait for me. It is not necessary that you wait for me, would be?
No es necesario que quede
que me,
para mí.
No, wait.
Ah, espera. Espere.
Right. Kim, you don't wait for your wait.
Oh, yes. Espere me. Me espere.
Right.
Que me espere.
Que me espere. Yes. Yes. No es necesario que me espere. Yes. To write is
escribir.
Escribir. Yes. Script. Scribble. Escribir. It's, of course, important to know that in Spanish you will never have any word that will start with SC or ST or SP. For a simple reason, they wouldn't know how to pronounce it. There's no SC, SP, ST. So therefore, to study would be estudiar. So therefore, she will have Hispanic students that will say estudiante. They have to learn how to pronounce the English study, school. They will say, I'm going to a school, because it's escuela. So therefore, to script, or to write is escribir. You cannot say escribir. They wouldn't know how to pronounce it. It's always written escribir. Spain is not España, but España. Why don't you write to me, would be?
¿Por qué no me escribe?
Beautiful, yes. ¿Por qué? No me escribe. It's perfect. If you want to say, write to me, imperative.
Escriba me.
Right. It's not, you put it together because also it's spelled in one word.
Escriba me.
Right. Escriba me. Yes. Escriba me. Because it's very important that you write to me.
Porque es muy importante.
Es muy importante que
me escriba.
Right. Es muy importante que me escriba. So here you have the command tense, where you have to use that command tense as subjunctive. That is very important. In English, you can say, I want you to write to me. Or you can say, what you want me to do, I want you to do, I want him to do, whatever. Whereas in Spanish, you cannot. I repeat, you cannot literally say, I want you to write to me. If you say, I want you, they're very, very literal about it immediately. If you say, quiero, I want you, te quiero, in Spanish means, really, I want you, or I love you. You don't make it a distinction between I want you and I love you in Spanish. So they will say te quiero, which means I love you. I want you to write to me has to be in Spanish. I want that you write to me. What you want me to do is has to be in Spanish, not what do you want me, but what do you want that I do, that he do, that we do, and so on. After want that, automatically the command tense, which is easy for you now. So if you want to say, what do you want me to write to him?
Que quiere.
Que quiere. Que.
Que quiere. Que.
I write to him.
Le escriba.
Right. Que quiere que le escriba. You don't have to think of I. Escriba could be that I write to him, that you write to him, that he write, whatever. Of course, sometimes you may need a clarifier, and then you must say, que quiere, o que quieres, o que quieren, if you're asking several people, que yo. But in this case, yo becomes the clarifier, que yo le escriba. O que él le escriba, que ella le escriba. O quiero que usted le escriba. It's all the same escriba. Of course, when you get into the go-go's, it's very easy. They automatically all become gagas. So, I want you to do it, would be, I want that you do it. Quiero.
Quiero.
Quiero
que lo haga.
Right. Quiero que lo haga. Yes. Or if you're talking to Roberto, I want you to do it.
Quiero. Quiero que lo hagas.
Right. Quiero que lo hagas. And you're talking to several people, I want all of you to do it.
Quiero que lo hagan. Hagan.
Right. Quiero que lo hagan. Hagan. And if you want to say, what do you want me to do?
Que quiere que
that
yo.
I do.
Yo.
Uh-huh.
Haga.
Right. Que quiere que yo haga. O que quiere que haga. If it's understood, or your haga could be as a clarifier or for emphasis, what you want me to do. Que quiere que yo haga. Why don't you want me to tell it to him?
Por qué no me quiere?
Guess why don't you want me?
Por qué no quiere que. Le diga.
Yes, you just said correctly. Why don't you want me to tell him? How would you say, why don't you want me to tell it to him?
Por qué no quiere.
It's a little more push.
Por qué no quiere.
Right.
Que se lo diga.
Right. Por qué no quiere. Que se lo diga, porque yo se lo diga,
yo se lo diga.
If you need a clarifier, yo se lo diga, que él se lo diga, que ella se lo diga. If you want to say, I think that he can do it.
Pienso que.
Pienso que. He can do it.
Puede hacerlo.
Right. Pienso que puede hacerlo. Yes.
I was trying to make it that he can do it. I was trying to make it subjective.
You see, if you say, I think that he can do it, then you don't express a doubt or an uncertainty. If you were to say, I don't think he can do it, now you have an element of doubt, of uncertainty. And then what will you do with can? Instead of puede, you will say
pueda.
Right. Pueda. So no pienso que pueda, meaning I don't think that he may be able. That is the maybe. So I want you to call me later.
Quiero que me llame más tarde.
Very good. Quiero que me llame más tarde. I want you to write to me.
Quiero que me escriba.
Right. Quiero que me escriba. He wants me to send it to him.
Quiere que lo mende, lo se lo mande.
Right. Very good. Yes. Quiere, or él quiere que se lo mande. Que se lo mande. Or que se lo mande a él, or a ella, or a usted. That is the subjunctive. But you see the importance, the high importance of using the stress, or sometimes I call it the push, penultimate syllable, on the syllable before last. That push, that stress is a signal also to you for comprehension and also in reading to know that it is either present tense or imperative command or the command tense, which is a subjunctive. Yes. Spanish ears, when they hear that push, then they know it's present command or subjunctive. Intermediately, they tune in